As it is right now, we're actually giving you a pretty cool tool in the resume. If you want to make a map appear at the bottom, it's actually really easy. Let's scroll down and take a look at it. We can see this great Where I've Lived and Work map. Here we can see place markers for all the places where James has worked. To add this to your resume, it's actually pretty simple. I'm going to open up DevTools again. And in the Sources pane, and I've added this line to my resumebuilder.js. I've added mapdiv.append Google Map. Inside Helper.js, we've got some functions set up that make it really easy for you to add a map that automatically puts place markers where you've lived and worked. Add this to your code and see what happens. The functions in Helper.js are using the JSONs that you created in resumebuilder.js. It iterates through their locations, it runs Google searches on all those locations, and then uses the results to put pins on the map. It's pretty awesome, and there's actually going to be a quiz in the practice problem section after this lesson, where you'll be able to break it apart to see how it works.
But beyond a Google map, you have tons of options for making your resume interesting and interactive. For starters, try editing the resume CSS to style it the way that you want. If you're unfamiliar with CSS, check out our course on HTML and CSS. It's in the instructor's notes.
Or you can even use a library like D3 to add a chart that helps people visualize your skills.
I like that one. It's worth poking around D3 to check out the really cool charts, graphs, and visualizations you can easily add to your resume.
And while you're at it, check out the links in the instructor's notes to other cool resumes we found online. Get some inspiration and try customizing yours.